Hello everyone, and welcome to Layered Connectivity's tutorial on getting started with Zephyr RTOS. Today, we're going to show you how to bring up the Blinky sample app on the BL652 and BL654 Bluetooth modules. So let's get started. First, let's have a look at the tools that we're going to need. We're going to need a BL652 dev kit, and for that we have a couple of options, the onboard and the external antenna version of the dev kit. We're also going to need a BL654 dev kit, and just like the BL652, we have an onboard and an external antenna version of the dev kit. We're going to need an Ubuntu version 20.0 for Linux PC. You can also use 18.04, but for this tutorial, we're going to use the 20.04 version of Ubuntu. Next, let's have a look at our setup. The Ubuntu PC, loaded with the Zephyr development environment, will connect to the dev kit via the USB 2 port. Then we're going to flash the Blinky app into the module. And if we did everything right, LED1 on the dev kit should blink after a reboot. So I already have the PC and dev kits, so the next step is to set up the Zephyr development environment on the PC. And for that, we're going to reference the step-by-step guide from our GitHub page. So this guide is pretty much the same exact steps that's on the Zephyr Project Getting Started page, except we added an extra step to install the NRF command line tools. So let's go ahead and install the development environment. Step 1. Update the OS. In my case, I just did an update recently, so this shouldn't take that long to complete. However, if you have a fresh install of Ubuntu, this step can take a few minutes to complete. Step 2. Install dependencies and verify the CMake version. If for some reason you don't have CMake version 3.13.1 or later, make sure you visit the Zephyr Getting Started page for additional steps on how to update CMake. Step 3. Get Zephyr and install Python dependencies. First, we need to install WES, which is Zephyr's command line tool. Next, add the local bin directory to our path environment variable in the bashrc file. Then source the bashrc file. Then we go ahead and get the Zephyr source code. Then export the Zephyr CMake package. Then use pip3 to install additional Python dependencies. Step 4. Install toolchain. First, go to the home directory and use the wget command to retrieve the Zephyr SDK. Next, run the installer to install the SDK. Then, install the UDEV rules to allow us to flash our board as a regular user. Step 5. Install the NRF command line tools. To install the tools, we first need to download it from the Nordic Semiconductor website. Since I've already downloaded and extracted the files, I can go ahead and install them. Step 6. Build the Blinky app. To build the app, we'll use the west build command with the -b auto option to do an auto clean before the build. Then we'll use the -b option to set the board name for the dev kit that we're going to be using. And then we'll provide the path to the app that we're going to build. For the BL652, we're going to use the board name BL652_DVK. And then for the BL654, we're going to use the board name BL654_DVK. So let's go ahead and build it for the BL652. The build finished without errors, so we can go ahead and flash it onto the module using the west flash command. So now, you should see LED1 blinking. Next, let's build it for the BL654. Then flash it. You should see LED1 blinking also. And here's a shot of the LEDs blinking on the dev kits. So that completes our tutorial. We hope that you find this helpful, and thank you for watching.